With a set of cars ready to be merged, open the museum file you worked on last. You can also use the file name museumcars.max. Using Import Merge, merge the mycars.max file you had just saved. Move the vehicles closer to the front of the museum building. This is the main intersection you will be rendering. There are many ways to animate vehicles. Short of using a traffic simulation plugin, the most common way is to constrain a car to a path. If the motion is simple, such as going from point A to point B in a straight line, you can also keyframe the position. For example, let's say the bus is moving along the street before it stops at the red light. In fact, there's a bus stop at this corner hidden from view at this time. Before you animate the bus, consider your timeline. The animation length is set to 100 frames by default. That's about 3 seconds using an NTSC signal of 30 frames per second. You'll need to extend that to about 20 seconds or 600 frames. This is done in the Time Configuration dialog. Next, you animate the bus by moving it along its road lane. To animate the motion, ensure Auto Key Mode is enabled. Go to frame 300, and then move the bus towards the intersection. Play the animation. The bus moves and stops at frame 300. And is immobile for the remainder of the animation. However, the motion of the bus seems to be accelerating in the beginning and decelerating at the end. Deceleration is good, as the bus is braking to a stop. However, and given its starting position, we have to assume it's already moving at a constant speed. To adjust the speed and timing, right-click the selected bus and go to the curve editor. In this particular case, you are interested in the y-axis, displaying the motion of the bus. Notice the curve, how it starts and ends in a shallow mode to become more pronounced in the middle. Select the first key, representing the beginning of the animation, and adjust the tangent to get a linear speed at the beginning and a deceleration at the end. If you feel the bus is moving too slowly, then you can adjust the timing. If the bus needs a shorter time to reach its destination, then change the end key to finish earlier, maybe somewhere between frames 200 and 250. Adjust the curves accordingly and exit the curve editor and auto key mode when done. Playback the animation. Go back to frame 0 when done. As mentioned earlier, while keyframing works well in certain simple situations, it is common to constrain moving vehicles to paths. This is done by first drawing a path using the line tool. Make sure it's set to corner-corner modes as a starting point. You can modify that later. Draw a line along this road lane. Hold shift to use ortho mode. Select one of the cars you imported, and then use Animation, Constraints, Path Constraint, and then click the line you drew. Two things happen. The car is relocated to the beginning of the path, and is now animated to travel along the path. You still need to adjust it, though. Zoom in on it, and notice it's pointing the wrong way. In the Motion panel, set it to Follow the Path. If anything, it's even worse. You still need to set the travel axis correctly. Try all three. The y-axis seems to work best, but it needs to be flipped. Play the animation. The motion seems a little slow, even for a safe driver. There are a couple of things you can do. First, you can extend or shorten the path by moving its vertices. Second, and most importantly, you can adjust the timing. With the car selected, go to the curve editor. Unlike earlier where you were dealing with position axes, here you are dealing with a percent track. This track is effectively telling you that the car is at 0% of path travel at the beginning of the animation, and that 100% of path travel at the end of the animation at frame 600. In this case, you want the car to reach the intersection earlier, as you did with the bus. Select the second keyframe and change it from frame 600 to 200. The car is now reaching the intersection quite a bit earlier. However, two things remain. It is slightly overshooting the stop line, and it is stopping abruptly. Past frame 200, the car is at the end of the path, or 100% of path travel. At 100%, the car's front is overshooting the mark. Reduce the percent value so that the car doesn't annoy pedestrians crossing the street. In my case, a value of about 97% seems about right. Looking at the animation curve, it's obviously linear, and there are no tangents to adjust speed. This is because the percent track is set to a linear controller by default. You can change that by switching it to a Bezier controller. This is done by first selecting the track, and then assigning a controller with a right click. This will let you adjust the curve, and the speed of the vehicle. Test the animation. Let's try another more complex one with a path that turns a corner. Draw an L-shaped line using Shift for ortho mode. In the Modify panel, use the Fillet command to round off the corner vertex. You can obviously use another car that you merged, but ultimately you will need to duplicate the vehicle you have already animated. You can do that by selecting an animated car and pressing Ctrl-V. Choose Instance and press OK. And then go to the motion panel. Currently, the duplicate follows the original, being constrained to the same path. In the motion panel, click on Delete Path to remove that constraint. Use Add Path to relocate the duplicated car to the new path. Click Add Path again to exit that mode. The car is now constrained to the new path, but its speed needs adjusting. It needs to slow down for the right turn. Scrub the animation and take note of the path travel. The car reaches the intersection at about path percent 44. This may be different on your system based on how you drew the line. Take note of that value. The car should decelerate reaching this percentage of path travel. It should then move at a constant slow speed around the bend until it reaches path percent 56 and then accelerate out of the corner. In the curve editor, use the Add Keys button to add two keyframes to that curve. Using Move Keys again, select the first added key, the second on the curve, and set its value to 44, where the car reaches the intersection. Now select the second inserted key, the third on the curve, and set its value to 56, marking the car exiting the turn. Ultimately, you have to adjust the timing and the tangents until the animation feels right. If you have time, animate more cars and buses to your city environment. In the next movie, you'll use a version of the city with a few more animated vehicles and create and animate cameras.